resources, and that is why they have such good universities, that is why they are regularly featuring in the best universities in the world list. India is, just doesn't stand a chance for it. Next. Now here are a few career opportunities at the undergraduate level and at the postgraduate level, where a commerce graduate can also opt for careers in financial services as a financial consultant, stock broker, merchant banker, budget consultant, financial portfolio management, project formulation, tax consulting. Now the last one, that is tax consulting. Here only a commerce graduate gets an entry. He may try for the rest, but then only an MBA gets those jobs. Only an MBA. If he has an MBA, then he becomes a stockbroker, merchant banker, budget consultant, financial portfolio manager. But if he is an MCOM, he stands no chance in front of that MBA guy. He can only be a tax consultant. Jo last mein likha hai, wahi kuch kar payega, commerce graduate. And that is the irony of the situation. Some innovations, thanks to the rapid changes that are taking place in the world of information and communication technology, some changes are taking place. And the latest being the mobile commerce. Mobile phones hold a lot of promise for the conduct of business. However, the starting point to achieving this promise is to understand the concepts behind application of mobile phone to business. And that is, M-commerce can be defined as any transaction with a monetary value that is conducted via a mobile telecommunications network. Typically, M-commerce takes place in a strategic platform called a mobile portal. M-commerce is not just a transaction, but it extends to provide services and information. For example, M-commerce is seen to possess some mobile applications which are used to provide a number of services. These services include mobile banking, payment information, and marketing services. M-commerce has been considered to be either one of these concepts. It is a technology, it is a product, or is it a service? And it is in fact an interaction of technology, product and services, and the buying and selling of goods and services and information without any location restriction by mobile devices, which uses a wireless connection to establish communication barriers between all the necessary parties to complete the transaction. The slide now shows you some benefits that are as the, because of M-commerce in terms of feature, in terms of benefits, and in terms of attributes. These again are the major applications. M-commerce, it is the latest mantra. As I told you at the beginning, do I have time? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, as in the beginning I told you I am a positivist, and I am very keen to link the changes in commerce education, changes in higher education to sustainable development. Briefly, I would like to show you a few things regarding what is sustainable development. All of you know. Next. Sustainable development, the meaning where at the core of the idea of sustainability is the matter of meeting people's needs for a home, for a decent job, for an education for the children, for good health. And if sustainable development does not take place, then what happens? Next. In this, you see, as such, the role of commerce education assumes greater importance in promoting the concept of sustainable development. If sustainable development does not take place, this is what is going to happen. If sustainable development is not put in the agenda, where there are the three pillars of sustainable development, and that is environmental, social, and economic, we need to harp upon the third one, where we can bring about changes in the commerce curriculum, and through that, sustainable development can take place. Next. The three spheres of sustainability, For all those keen students, I'll be leaving behind all these, which you can go through at leisure, at length. And these are the mechanical drivers of sustainability. The mechanical drivers being for to reduce encroachment upon nature, to reduce dependence on synthetic chemicals and other natural substances, to reduce dependence upon fossil fuels, underground materials, and so other things. And next, these are the crisis as a result of if sustainable development is not focused upon. There will be climate crisis, food crisis, energy crisis, economic and financial crisis. And the symptoms of a crisis are like these. You can see for yourself the devastation that takes place all over the world. And education can be the cornerstone for sustainable development, where everybody has started recognizing that education needs to be harnessed into support sustainable development of the society. Next. And all countries, including the United Kingdom, they have a firm resolve that it should be included. And the role of commerce education with sustainable development. Why? Because commerce tries to satisfy increasing human wants. Commerce helps to increase our standard of living. Commerce links producers and consumers. Commerce generates employment opportunities. Commerce increases national income and wealth. Commerce involves lifelong learning. So, ladies and gentlemen, I have run out of time, and I wish to conclude by saying that commerce has been ignored, not by anyone else, but by us. It is time to acknowledge the guilt. It is time to wake up. It is time to overhaul this situation. And at the same time, my firm belief is that if the curriculum is overhauled, revolutionized, radically revolutionized, and brought in sync with sustainable development, we will see a better tomorrow for India and for our future generations. Namaskar.